What would make you not run for president?
Well,
what would be a compelling influence?
It would be wholly personal. It would be that I'm about to have my first grandchild, which I'm thrilled
about.
Can't wait. I want to see what that feels like. I'm not going to skip over it. I want to really be present as I meet this, new person in our family. I like my life right now. I like the opportunity to do what I'm interested in, pursue very important issues to me, like our foreign policy issues, which is why I wrote the book. So I'm very keen on, seeing how this feels personally. So it is a personal decision, ultimately, because I have seen it up close now for more than 20 years, both with my husband and, honestly, with President Bush after 9/11. He became a very good partner to us here in New York as we had to rebuild. And then...
As he said, it changed his presidency as well.
Totally. And it's what I spent my first term as senator basically doing, was trying to help, rebuild New York and take care of people who'd been affected. And then, obviously, being so close with President Obama. So I have no illusions about how hard a campaign is. But the campaigning, as hard as it is the easy part. Once you get there and you face this array of problems.
I promise you, I don't want to have a conversation about are you running for president. But I do want to understand the nature of a choice to run for president.
Right, right.
Well, and how one approaches that and how one gets to the point. Because it is not only because of the experience you've had inside the White House, in the Senate, go around the world, understanding what the power of office can do for better, for good, or for bad. But at the same time, you're looking at history.
Right, yeah.
You are looking at history.
That's true, Charlie. And I
can't...
And
you spent a lot of time talking about the power and the encouragement and the place of women in our society.
Yes, I have.
And this is a powerful signal.
I feel
it will send.
I feel that very strongly. And, hard choices are not necessarily the same for everybody. For some people, running for president seems like the next step on
a
career.
A
and it's not hard at all because they want to do it. They feel compelled to do it. And up until this point, it's been, predominantly men who have done it. And they come to that choice with a lot of commitment and confidence. Many of them run for reasons having to do with a particular point of view or maybe, to sort of finish off their own sense of identity, whatever it might be. Because I know so much about the job and how hard it is, I am very struck by the historic nature of a campaign that I might in the future undertake, because I could feel it in 08. And as I write, it was so historically unprecedented to have a campaign about race and gender for the first time in our country, which, was amazing and I think to our benefit. But I also know that the job has only gotten harder. The job is a all-consuming commitment for obvious reasons. And when you think about it, when you think about it, in our country, we don't have a head of state, so all of the symbolic and sort of ritualistic aspects of a high-level position, as well as the hard work of politicking, lobbying, governing, operating the United States of America, is all in one person. We don't have a monarch, we don't have a president and a prime minister. So the job has gotten even bigger and more difficult. The government hasn't kept up with the changes technologically, for example, because, you got to get the money from the Congress to really improve what you're doing, personnel policies and all the rest. So the job is challenging as it's always been, but I would say almost to a degree of amplification that's hard to imagine.
Yeah, but I don't think for a moment that you would imagine that the job is too big for one person or the job is too big for you.
No,
I mean, you understand.
I understand. I understand how the job is done, and I understand what has to be prioritized. I just have to decide whether or not that's what I want to do at this point in my life. That's why I go back to it's a very personal choice.
Only one person can make that decision.
And only I can make that decision.